Back now at 7:43, and 4 months after the presidential election, a man who may have actually changed the course of the race is finally speaking out. That bartender who secretly recorded Governor Romney's now infamous 47% comments. NBC's White House correspondent Peter Alexander has that story. Peter, good morning.
Matt, good morning to you. Even today, some political observers insist without that 47% tape, we might actually be talking about President Mitt Romney these days. Instead, the infamous comments marked what was really a campaign game changer. And now, months later, the man behind that tape has finally come forward.
Well, there are 47% of the people who vote for the president no matter what. All right, there are 47% who are with him, who are dependent upon government, who believe that they're victims.
The man behind that secret Romney recording is Scott Prouty, a bartender at that private Florida fundraiser last May.
I was behind this whole thing.
Speaking publicly for the first time Wednesday, Prouty, who says he's a registered independent, told MSNBC's Ed Schultz he arrived at the dinner that night with an open mind.
I was interested to hear what he had to say. I didn't go there with a grudge, you know, against Romney.
Prouty insisted he brought his camera, initially thinking Romney might pose for pictures.
I had a Secret Service agent behind me, and, you know, number one, we were never told that this was a secret meeting or a private meeting or don't bring cameras. There was plenty of people in the room with cameras. You know, at this point, I realized that this was not your typical speech.
For 2 weeks, Prouty says he struggled over whether to go public with the tape before he says he finally decided he had no choice.
I felt an obligation for all the people that can't afford to be there. You shouldn't have to be able to afford $50,000 to hear what the candidate actually thinks.
Earlier this month, Romney reiterated his commitment to all Americans, but conceded the 47% comments did real damage to his campaign.
That was a very unfortunate statement that I made. It's not what I meant. I didn't express myself as I wished I would have. You know, when you speak in private, you don't spend as much time thinking about how something could be twisted and distorted and could come out wrong and be used. But, you know, I did, and it was very harmful.
Only after hearing that interview did Prouty, who says he voted for Obama, decide to come forward and reveal his role in a dramatic twist to a historic campaign.
I had no idea what was going to be this big thing that it turned out to be.
Certainly turned out to be a big thing. We reached out to the Romneys last night for comment and were directed to that recent interview that we just showed you. But even last night, Matt, one of the governor's top campaign advisors told me that the release of that tape last summer stunned the staff, that the governor, I was told, even apologized to them for the mess that he had caused. And even now, I still remember exactly what another frustrated advisor told me at the time. He said, when you're running for president, you've got to know that the camera is always on.
All right, Peter Alexander in Washington. Peter, thanks very much.